guy locked trapped in a car with a drunk driver. A ride to the office for two women turned into a nightmare. This incident happened in the National Capital Region, where a drunk driver allegedly child-locked two women in his car and threatened bodily harm as they tried desperately to get out of the car. Mirror Now has been highlighting how dangerous child locks can be in public transport, especially taxis, and now yet another case emerges.
Something very important we need to all realize about taxis. There is a definite data to suggest that most of the crimes that have happened against women in taxis have happened because the car was child locked. And if the car is child locked, as a passenger in the back seat, you cannot open the door and you cannot roll down the windows, because the master switch for the windows is with the driver. Most of the cars that operate as taxis today are mid-range sedans, and most of them come with an automatic basic child lock facility. Here's what you can do, and here's what you must tell all of your family members to do. This is a taxi, for example, that we've called around. It's a standard vehicle. Now, before you get into that vehicle, here's what you can do. You open the door to get in. I'm going to ask the camera to come in. Here, this is the physical child lock facility. It's unlocked now. If it's pushed that way, it's locked. It's marked very clearly on all cars. Before you get into the car, check for this facility. If it is locked, this is what happens. You get in. Locked car, you can only open the door from the outside, which means that the passenger in the back of the car is effectively trapped. There is only one way to stop it. Every time you get into a car that is not yours, you have to check for the switch. It will take a moment, but it is so important. Make sure that the switch is off. The other thing we are going to do as a channel at Mirror Now is ask for all state governments, and every state has to do it, is to put a sticker on the car instructing every passenger to check the child lock and make sure the child lock is not on. The more important thing for the governments to do is to make sure that if a car is registered as a commercial vehicle or a taxi, the child lock is effectively taken away completely, because it's completely unnecessary in a taxi. You only need child locks in private cars. We appeal to the government to make this change, but I appeal to you to actually let as many of your family members know that this is an important thing.
A shocking case is coming in from NCR. A woman and her friend were child-locked, trapped in a car with a drunk driver. This incident happened in the National Capital Region, where a drunk driver allegedly child-locked two women in his car and threatened bodily harm as they tried desperately to get out of the car. And joining me on the phone line is Apoorva. Apoorva, this case clearly highlights that why we should do away with child locks.
Absolutely. In fact, this particular incident again puts the focus back on how child lock really is working against the safety of women. In fact, this particular incident was came to light today morning when these two girls who were at the metro station waiting for a cab, they got into the cab, and after some very heated discussion with the cab driver, it was only then that the cab driver got out of the car and he had child locked it. And the two girls tried to get out of the car, and to their horror and to their surprise, they were not able to come out of the car. And at the same time, they saw the driver cross the road on the other side and was maliciously looking at both of them, and that really terrified the two girls. So it was only then that they immediately called up their friend, someone who was nearby, to immediately come and just open the door. And that is how this entire incident came to light, again putting the focus back on how it is about time that we do away with child lock. Of course, this matter again, there has been a series of such incidents that has been reported, but this has just again put the focus back on how people are, how drivers are really abusing the child lock.
Right, Apoorva. Also, has the woman and her friend complained to the police so far?
Well, yes, the victim, in fact, because she was really shaken by this entire thing, did go to the police and also tried filed a complaint against the driver. And the police told the victim to file a case under Section 506, which is outraging the modesty of a woman. But then this woman was so shaken that she did not know what to do. So right now, she hasn't filed a formal complaint. She's of course speaking to a lot of her lawyers as well in this case. But the police have filed a challan. The car has been impounded, and the victim will be talking to the police again sometime, because this happened today morning. She will be taking up this case as well.
Right, Apoorva. As a matter of fact, the DCW has said that child lock increases possibility of crimes in cabs, and they're also seeking a removal.
Absolutely. There was a notification by the DCW which had highlighted the kind of misuse of child lock and how it would be greatly used for crime against women. And these are such examples that really highlight the greater need to removal of these child locks, because we have seen past incidents as well when child lock has been used to secure the fact that women will not be able to get out of the car. And at that point in time, there is also a need for awareness to understand that whenever you're getting inside a cab, be it any rental cab or any kind of cab, even if it is an office shuttle, there is a bigger need for everybody to be aware as to where the child lock is. That one awareness also needs to be there among everyone to understand that they're not trapped inside the car when the driver puts on the child lock. But of course, as the DCW notification has also come out stating the ill effects of child lock and how it is being greatly used against crime against women, and that is also another important aspect. So it is about time that the Transport Ministry really looks into this matter so that no untoward incident really takes place as far as the child lock cases are concerned.